Well, a former lawmaker calls allegations of bribery and the push for charter change ridiculous. Alfredo Garbin Jr. says such claims should not be given weight since there is no evidence to back it up. For Garbin, 100 pesos in exchange for supporting charter change is too cheap.
It was refuted by no less than the president of the league, Mayor Sobalbay, Mayor Salceda, that there was no flow of funds with the purview of, you know, distributing the same to buy votes, your carry. So why should it be considered or be given any consideration or given any greater weight? As we speak from now, wala naman na lumalabas at nagsasabing pumirma sila dahil sa 100 pesos. Napaka-cheap naman nun. What I'm saying here is that the people and the those who are the prime movers of this movement should explain to the Filipino people what is really the intention of this people's initiative.
Garbin adds even the president's sister, Senator Aimee Marcos, could have wrong information on the issue.
She could be wrong, as stated by the Secretary of Labor, that there was no release of funds for the purpose of, you know, convincing the beneficiaries to sign the purported people's initiative. And she could be wrong, because these are, you know, lead agencies of the government who are now saying that no such thing exists.
Albay Representative Edsa Lagman first raised the issue, claiming the Acol Bicol party list distributed money to Albay mayors to buy votes in support of a so-called people's initiative to amend the constitution. Garbin was a former representative of that party list. He was also present during the meeting with the Albay mayors. Philippine lawmakers begin their probe into alleged corruption in government's POV modernization program. Philippine transport officials have been accused of favoring imported modern jeepney units that are more expensive, but they insist they don't have a say on the brand of vehicles the transport cooperatives will buy.
Wala ho kaming pinagbabasiyan kung to imported or local. The price is that is a fixed subsidy po doon sa sasakyan. And yung pagbili po ng sasakyan ay nasa kooperatiba ho yun. Wala, hindi ho saklaw ng LTFRB or ng DOTR kung ano po yung bibili nilang sasakyan. At base po sa datos ho namin, I think more than 60% ng mga nabili pong sasakyan ay locally manufactured vehicles po.
House lawmakers also questioned transport regulators on the implementation of the program, as well as fears of a possible spike in fare rates.
Kanina, ang main objective, sabi po ng DOTR, bakit nag-modernize ay ng jeepney ay dahil daw po doon sa air pollution. Pero ang ibig bang sabihin, sinisisi ninyo o yung mga jeepneys o yung mga PUB na sila talaga yung nagkakos ng air pollution sa ating bansa. Naging solution ninyo, modernization, consolidation ng prangkisa, magsasubsidize o utang ang kooperatiba sa banko, pero hindi nyo nakita yung naging epekto nito, no, doon sa ating mga, Mr. Chair, epekto nito sa ating mga drivers, epekto nito sa commuters.
Dapat mapag-aralan which is which. Yung 900,000 pesos cost per unit o 2.8 million pesos per unit. Kung wala ang LTFRB na assessment, Mr. Chief, based on my personal evaluation, magiging 30 to 40 pesos ang pamasahe ng ating mga kababayan.
Philippine Finance Chief Benjamin Diokno sees an aggressive policy easing from the central bank this year. He told Bloomberg TV the Banco Central could match the expected rate cuts of the Fed and could lower rates by as much as 100 basis points. The former central bank governor sits as a member of the BSP's monetary board. His remarks came after the BSP said its borrowing rates will remain sufficiently tight in the near term, with inflation risks still leaning on the upside. It also followed the release of the December inflation print, which showed consumer prices declining to a 22-month low of 3.9%. Ahead of the full implementation of the 1% withholding tax on online sellers, the Bureau of Internal Revenue asserts the measure should not result in higher prices of goods. Jackie Pascual reports.
Businessman Lucito Chavez owns a bake shop in Manila, but he also sells through food delivery apps and an online shopping app. He says he is surprised to hear about the impending imposition of 1% creditable withholding tax on half of the gross remittances made by electronic marketplaces to online sellers like him. Though he is not against taxes, he says government must first focus on protecting the rights of consumers against online shopping scams. He said he was a victim of it in many instances.
There should be a policies, regulation for the protection of the consumer in return to the 1% na hinihingi sa amin ng pamahalaan. Sana bago magpataw ang gobyerno ng buwis, aralin muna nila ito para naman hindi maapektuhan ang mamamayang Pilipino.
Bureau of Internal Revenue Commissioner Romeo Lumagi Jr. clarifies the policy on imposing withholding tax is not a new tax. This is why he said that prices of goods should not increase because of this regulation.
Hindi tayo nagpapataw ng panibagong buwis. So walang bagong binabayarang buwis. Ang binabayarang buwis dito ay income tax. Pagka kumikita po tayo, generally, kailangan po magrehistro dito sa aming ahensya at kailangan magbayad ng buwis.
He adds those earning 500,000 pesos or less annually are exempted from the withholding tax system, so micro and small businesses need not worry. Aside from online shopping apps and food delivery apps, e-wallet platforms are also covered by this new system, affecting shops, even physical stores with a business account on e-wallet firms. Lumagi adds there is a need to focus on policies covering online transactions as many businesses are already online.
Nagrereklamo rin naman yung mga nasa brick and mortar stores na nagbabayad sila ng tamang buwis na madali silang i-monitor. Pero ngayon, naglilipatan ngayon ang dami sa online selling.
He hopes more businesses will register with the BIR as electronic marketplaces would also urge merchants to register. This, he said, will also help consumers in case there is a need to file a complaint against an erring company. The new policy is on a transition period and may be fully implemented within the first quarter of the year. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.
Meralco's power rates going up this January. The power distributor will implement an 8 centavo per kilowatt hour increase in this month's power bills. This translates to a projected increase of 17 pesos for those consuming an average of 200 kilowatt hours per month. Meralco attributes the hike to an increase in the prices of electricity in the spot market. The Philippines' young demographic is usually touted as one of the country's best assets, but a study shows the Philippine population is actually aging. Ara Perez with a full story.
Millennial couple Christian and Griselda are satisfied with having only two children. For them, a small family is ideal, particularly after the challenges brought by the COVID-19 pandemic and rising cost of living.
Nagmamahal yung bilihin, nagmamahal yung mga needs po ng mga bata. Sinasabi po namin sila, magpaparami ka ngayon ng anak, paano yung pagkain nila, paano yung ano nila. Tayo po yung nagbuo ng pamilya eh. Kumbaga kung ano yung kailangan ng pamilya natin, tayo magsusuporta.
Natututukan din po namin sa pag-aaral niya, masusuportahan namin. Kasi dalawa lang sila.
According to the Commission on Population and Development, the Boado family situation is becoming the norm. That's why the Commission estimates that by 2030, the United Nations may consider the Philippines as an aging population, where there is an increase in the percentage of older Filipinos.
Masasabi ko po, patuloy po tayong dadami, pero bumabagal, kumukonti ang pagdami. Ang ibig pong sabihin, tayo po ang ating mga 60 and above po ay mga 7% of the population. Naka-apekto talaga ang COVID-19. So kumonti kasal, tapos yung mga kababaihan, medyo kumukonti yung nanganak. So tingnan po natin, at saka isa pa po, dumami din po yung mortality natin. At saka may mga pagbabago sa fertility intentions and behavior ng kababaihan.
An aging population comes with it a host of problems and challenges. A sociologist shares, in Filipino culture, having a child is considered a blessing. But more people are now more deliberate in starting a family, given the pressures of modern living.
Yung mga bansa kasi na aging population, eventually magkakaroon sila ng problema. Bakit? Because when a population is aging, ibig sabihin nun, yung kanilang pondo for social security, nadideplete yun. But the problem is, because walang mga bata, di walang magtatrabaho para malagyan ng pondo yung social security. So they are now relying on who? Migrant workers. Para ngayon, yung kanilang social security, at least, malagyan ngayon ng tinatawag ng mga funds.
Bersales points out the projected population of the Philippine Statistics Authority, based on the 2015 census, has also decreased from 115 million by the end of 2023 and as 2024 enters to just 112 million upon the start of 2024. The Philippine situation is not yet alarming, but Sorita sees a changing mindset, particularly among the younger people.
When you parent a child, when you bring up a child, diba, you have to devote time. And that is a question of availability in terms of career and parenting. So, issue yon sa maraming mga, you know, generations ngayon na feeling nila they have to devote more time on career. Parang nag-evolve kasi yung ating belief system in terms of looking at a child. Diba, nung araw, sabi ko nga eh, kung ang batay kayamanan, ba't mo siya sabihin hadlang siya sa pag-develop mo ng career mo? So,
whether or not to have children is the decision of a woman and a couple. But whatever the trend, experts cite the importance of responsible parenthood. Bersales says that and family planning are essential to ensure a population can provide for its needs and requirement for human capital development. The United Nations World Social Report 2023 says, population aging is an irreversible global trend, which is a result of demographic transition or the trend towards longer lives and smaller families that is also happening in countries with relatively youthful populations. Ara Perez, ABS-CBN News.